Hi guys, it's John here, and this is another benchmark comparison test between the Galaxy S22 Ultra and the Galaxy S23 Ultra. So they're both now finally on the August update. The S22 got its update about a week ago now, and the S23 only got it this morning. So we're going to run through the usual tests here with Geekbench 6 to start with, followed by AnTuTu, and then 3DMark, and then our browser test. Now you can see here, I charged these both up to 100%. We're only down to 97% on the S22, and it has been running at least one, currently 2 degrees hotter than the S23 since I've had them off the charge. Now, obviously the starting percentage of battery doesn't really matter too much, but it will be interesting to see how things go now that the S22 is getting a bit older now. So at the weekend, we've finally hit 50,000 subscribers. So thank you so much for everyone who has hit that subscribe button. Really does mean a lot. Hopefully we can get to 100,000 one day. I probably don't push it as much as I should, but yeah, please do like and subscribe. It really does help out. And thanks also to those who have become members, some of you for quite a long time. It is really appreciated, and it helps me pay towards things to get more content for you guys to watch. Right, so the Geekbench 6 CPU test is now finished. So the results are pretty similar to last month, to be honest. The noticeable difference is that the S23 does stay about 2 degrees cooler than the S22 throughout all of those tests. So the averages are on the screen at the moment. So again, yeah, nothing really interesting to talk about there. So we'll move on to the compute or the GPU test now, run three of these and see how they do there. Okay, so the GPU scores are in, and again, pretty much zero difference compared to last month. This time the S23 was staying about 3 degrees cooler than the S22 Ultra. So those are the only major differences really, apart from the fact that obviously the score on the S23 is still significantly better than the S22 Ultra. Battery wise, we're down to 89% on the S22 Ultra and 94% on the S23 Ultra. Okay, so we can see last month's scores here. So let's run through the AnTuTu benchmark again and see how they get on. Starting with 34 degrees and 31 degrees. So again, the S23 is still staying a lot cooler than the S22. So the AnTuTu benchmark's just finished. I did run a couple of them as we were a bit low on space on the S22 Ultra, so it wouldn't have been a fair test. So the second test here, we can see that it's actually improved. We've got 1.01 million on the S22 Ultra. We've got 1.491 million on the S23 Ultra. So again, not really major difference here compared to last month. So what we will do now is the stress test, and this is where hopefully we will see a big difference. Last month, the stress test on the S23 Ultra, as you can see, was pretty horrendous. So I will give these a couple more minutes to cool down, but then we'll move on to the 50-minute stress test and see how they do. Okay, so the AnTuTu stress test is just finished, and we can see slightly better results compared to last month. S22 Ultra, let's start with this first, and we can see here a pretty reasonable average of around 70 to 80% for most of the first half of the test. We do drop a bit down here, down to the 50, 60%, which sort of carries on getting steadily better towards the end of the test. CPU cores are, as they always are, going all over the place, but they are keeping up nicely above 2 GHz for most of the test, certainly on Core 7. Core 6 is always down a bit below that. Going on to the S23 Ultra now, we can see here the performance is doing really well here, staying at around 80% performance for the majority of the test. This is better than it was last month, but we do then see this dip down after the 11-minute mark, down to around 65%. So that's a bit of a shame, but we are actually improving over last month, which is good to see. And you can see that with the cores getting clocked down here, slowly sloping down to the 2.2 gigahertz mark here towards the end of the test. So better than last month, but still not as good as we saw at the launch of the phone, where we were seeing straight lines across the whole board on the S23 Ultra. Temperature-wise, 39 and 40. And battery-wise, we're down to 66 on the S22 Ultra and 73 on the S23 Ultra. Okay, so I've let the phones cool down a bit now, and we're going to run through the 3DMark tests. We're going to start with the Wildlife Extreme stress test and then move on to the Slingshot Extreme. Okay, so the Wildlife Extreme has just finished, and you can see the results here. And there have been some nice improvements since last month, actually. So we're up about 200 points on the best loop and about 100 on the lowest loop for the S22 Ultra, so that's nice to see. Stability has gone down a tiny bit, but overall an improvement there, which is very good. Same on the S23 Ultra. We've gone up by about 200 points on the best loop and 200 points also on the lowest loop, with that stability increasing at the same time. So there's definitely been performance improvements on both phones here, which seems to be more of a rarity nowadays, but yeah, that's good to see. So let's move on to the Slingshot Extreme and see if we can carry on this nice improvement in performance. So the Slingshot Extreme's just finished, and again, we've seen improvements from both phones. You can see here, compared to last month, there's been a nearly 7.5% increase on the S22 Ultra, and on the S23 Ultra, we've seen just over 8% increase in the scores. So there's definitely been something happening on both phones in the background to get these nearly 10% increases on both. Okay, we are going to move on to the JetStream2 test now, and just see how the web browsing is compared to last month. JetStream test has finished on both, and a score of 106 on the S22 Ultra and 192 on the S23 Ultra, which is a nice improvement here for the S23 by about 8%. Bit of a decrease here, nearly 4% decrease compared to last month on the S22 Ultra, but again, take it with a bit of a grain of salt. These are still both great phones for browsing the internet or doing your doom scrolling. They're pretty quick, so I wouldn't be too upset about the big difference here. It's probably not something you're going to notice in normal day-to-day usage. Right, so at the end of the test, we are down to 47% on the S22 Ultra and 55 on the S23 Ultra. So about 8% difference between the two. But again, this has obviously been used for over a year now compared to the fresher battery in the S23 Ultra. But yeah, I hope you found this useful. If you did, please do like and subscribe. Don't forget to leave any comments you have down below, and I'll see you again in the next video.